The biggest event between China and Africa, called FOCAC, Forum of China-African Cooperation, is taking place as we speak in Beijing, China. This is truly a strong indication of how dynamic and how strong cooperation between China and Africa has become. And China firmly believes that its goal of promoting long-standing cooperation with all the African countries is for the mutual benefit of African countries on the one hand and China on the other hand. In more recent decades, China has been working very closely together with the African countries in building up connectivity projects like highways, railways, airports, seaports. China has been the largest trading partner with many African countries, and China has imported lots of things from Africa, and China has really never hesitated in helping setting up high-tech parks and bringing manufacturing capabilities to Africa. I think there is a spontaneous feeling between the Chinese people and the African people because we respect each other, we fully share with each other our expertise and our knowledge base, our know-how, and we want to see Africans become very successful. What China wants to work together with the African countries is what we call modernization with African characteristics, the African type of modernization, because China's paradigm, China's roadmap may or may not work for any of the African countries. They can learn from China, sometimes in substantial ways, but they cannot just take over the Chinese model and do that 100% unchanged in their own country, because they need to adapt whatever we have been doing in China to the specific circumstances in their own countries. Therefore, respecting African countries as equals is a precondition for any country's engagement with Africa. So one question naturally comes to mind is why the United States loathe China's engagement with Africa. I think the United States views China's engagement as part of the United States' plan of geopolitical maneuvering against China. On the other hand, the African countries have said on many occasions that they should be the final decision maker as far as their relations with China or their relations with the United States are concerned. The taste of the pudding is really in eating it, and it should be the African countries who should eat the pudding and tell everyone, tell the whole world, which pudding they like best. Fundamentally and philosophically, I think the real choice for African countries are not between China and the United States. The real choice is whether China or the United States will be doing the right thing. The real test of Americans' engagement with Africa, in my best judgment, is to create real benefit for the African people and to respect the African people, the African countries, as equals, rather than continuing to view Africa in a discriminatory frame of mind, try to see Africa as something inferior, for example, or try to see African values as different from the American values, and eventually try to impose American values on the African countries. China-African cooperation does not exclude African countries' cooperation with any other country, including the United States and many countries in Europe, if, for example, such cooperation can be on mutual basis and equal basis. I hope the United States will work together with China, Britain, Germany, France, Italy, Belgium, you name it, as well as Eastern European countries, will join hands with China to create greater benefits for African countries